In this video, we are going to discuss about compilers. So let's see what a compiler is. It is a system software that stores the complete program that we have written in the high level language, scans it, translates into object code, and then creates an executable code. What is an executable code? A code, a program that can run straight away is called an executable code that can be executed. Apparently, compilers compare unfavorably with the interpreters. Why? We discussed in our previous video about interpreters. I'm saying here that they are not better than interpreters. Why? Because they are more complex than interpreters. Why they are more complex? Because they are doing so many things. They are storing it, scanning it, and then converting it into executable code. It needs more memory space. Why? Because it is doing lots of functions. It takes more time in compiling the source code. Despite these disadvantages over the interpreter, we are doing this, we are using the compiler because the compiler gives us an executable code, a code that will run straight away. So if I am a programmer, I am a software developer, I'll write that code, I'll convert it into executable code and give it to the user. The user will just put it into his or her system and it will run straight away. Imagine if I just give an interpreted code or a source code or an object code, then what will happen? It has to be converted it into executable code at the end of the user. It will take lots of time and any user will have problems with that. Compiled programs execute very fast on the computers, like I told you just now. Let's see what are the steps that a compiler has to follow. This is the source code, the program that I have written in a high-level language. It does pre-processing. It does lexical analysis. It does parsing, then compiling, then it gets the object code. After the object code, it does some linking. And finally, it gets the executable code. These are the steps that a compiler follows. Let's see what each of these steps mean in detail. Pre-processing. In this stage, the preprocessor instructions are converted to assembly level language. What are preprocessor instructions? Every language, every high level language has some library of code that is already there for the user or the programmer to connect to, which are done using preprocessor instructions. So these are again instructions which are converted into the object code. Lexical analysis. All the instructions are broken down into lexical units. What are the lexical units? The constants, variables, symbols that make up any language are the lexical units. So in lexical analysis, the instructions are broken down. A list of variables will be made, a list of arithmetic operators will be made, a list of comparison operators that are being used in the whole program will be done. Parsing. Here all instructions are checked to see if they are following the grammatical rules of the language. Every language, every high level language will have its own rules. At parsing level, the compiler will check if it follows those rules or not. Compiling. Here, the source code finally gets converted into the object code. The complete program is interpreted line by line. And finally, linking. If there are any links to external files, addresses of their executable will be added to the program. In a real life situation, you don't write a standalone program. There will be many programs, 2, 3, 4 programs written separately and then combined together so that the whole software is developed. So each program, each individual program when it is compiled has to be linked with the other programs. This happens in the linking phase and once they all are linked with each other, we get the executable code. The final output is the executable code that is ready to be executed and handed over to the end user. So in this video, we have seen how a compiler works. In the next video, we are going to discuss about the functions of operating systems.